Pass me that THC Salve, please. Oh, wow. I sound good right now.
I'm feeling some kind of good.
So on this episode, we are going to talk about mainly indoor growing, how to grow indoors, cannabis, obviously.
Vendor day.
We'll tell you all about that, what that means. This THC Salve that I'm about to put on my stiff wrist that Ray just made. Homemade.
My obsession with the Puffco Peak and all different attachments.
The midterm elections and what states just got medically legal and recreational as well.
And then an event I'm very excited for coming up in December, Emerald Cup.
Yes, which is in Santa Rosa and it's December 14th and 15th.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah. But right now I'm rubbing in this THC salve and it feels pretty darn good already. It's got that peppermint in it. Let's just start off with that. How'd you make it?
Yeah, let's start off with that because I just got done rubbing myself up with it. And I was just thinking, and I'll explain why I love this, but it was so easy to make. And we're lucky that we have the magical butter machine to help with that. But I think that at home users could really maybe do some sort of double boiling method or potentially a crock pot. You know, of course, the magical butter machine does have that mechanism inside that cut. It's like some sort of blade almost. Mm-hmm. But either way, it really only took an hour,
which was a
short amount of time. And keep in mind, you guys, I did have the infused THC coconut oil was already made at this point. So, of course, that process is going to take a while and that in its own.
And that's the only infused part of it? Pretty much.
Pretty much. Okay. But I did add a little something special. So really all it was I got all of the ingredients from Whole Foods. It mainly contains almond oil.
Okay.
And I'm sure you can play around with the essential oils that are in it. But there's about 3 or 4 different essential oils. So there's lemon extract, eucalyptus, and I chose peppermint. There was another essential oil. It started with a C. I'd never heard of it. Canule or something. But if you go on magicalbutter.com, you can look it up. It's their basic salve. Okay. It's an almond oil salve recipe. And it's under their, I think, beauty and body or some sort of category.
But it was pretty easy to make, though.
Super easy. Yeah. So all I did was combine all of those ingredients. So the essential oils, and then I added my cannabis infused coconut oil, and I decided to throw in actual CBD dabs from Harley Sue last year that you grew in the garden.
Very cool.
So it does contain a little bit of CBD as well.
Okay.
But yeah, it was super easy to make. So I'm pretty sure, you know, for the hour at 160 degrees Fahrenheit, it really was probably just melting it down because you also, main ingredient I forgot to mention, beeswax, 100% beeswax.
Okay.
And I found that at Whole Foods, it actually was a candle and it was, one type of brand and they had, you know, a stick candle, some in a jar, whatever. So I got the basic stick.
And you just broke it down.
And I broke it down.
Okay.
And, that of course melted in with the essential oil.
So how did that make you feel? And what was like aching? What did you apply it to?
Well, so it did the hour too, and then it came out as a liquid. But once I was pouring it into the jars, it then re-solidified into this really great creamy texture.
Okay.
I could have also probably gotten those like deodorant stick type containers and poured it into one of those so that you could almost apply it as a balm.
Mm-hmm.
But I do like it in the jar. But for me, I was even just rubbing it on my hands and I was thinking, I don't have a labor intensive job, but if I did any sort of, you know, things with my hands or if I had arthritis or something, I mean, that's even an amazing application.
Yeah.
But I personally used it. My back was just hurting at work from sitting in my desk chair and I just applied a little bit on my lower back and
it doesn't smell like cannabis at all.
No, not at all. It's because the essential oil is so strong. Mm. The scent in it.
Yeah, the eucalyptus and the mint.
And I don't think the cannabis coconut oil is that strong. So once you even, you know, infuse that again, I think it loses a lot of its cannabis smell.
Yeah, I agree. And I have really stiff wrists this week. I was working on my car all weekend and just been lifting heavy over the past couple weeks, so my wrists have been very achy, low-key, and it is honestly relieved. Like, you don't notice it. It's not like a buzz. There's not like there's not like a cooling sensation. Honestly, you just don't feel the pain anymore. It feels like a lubricated joint, not like a stiff, dry, edgy joint. So when I rotate my wrist right now, it's very free. It's honestly just like as if you're to loop up a joint on a car or something like that. So,
well, and it's great too, because in topical form, it's not going to get you high.
Right.
So the THC properties are helping with you're exactly right, the pain relief.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not getting you stoned.
Correct. Yep. So this is great for the baby boomer and on generation, because they, as you know, getting older, you got all those aches and pains. This is really helpful. So, and it's not, there's not a stigma towards if you're just rubbing on a product. I mean, especially if it doesn't smell and that packaging doesn't have a huge weed leaf on it, I'm sure any grandpa or grandma can get away with rubbing that on themselves in public or what have you. Well,
the hilarious thing was, like I said, I was doing this at my desk in corporate America, and I'm just like, it doesn't even smell. No. Yeah. And of course my coworker next to me, are you rubbing on Icy Hot? Yeah. Yeah. My back was hurting. Yeah.
Yeah. It smells just like
they
don't
know.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it really, the pain relieving effects were great. And honestly, I had one of my friends I had been experimenting with, because I was also at one point using the CBD Santa Cruz medicinals coconut oil,
okay,
and rubbing that on as a topical.
Mm-hmm.
Which that also works very well, but when you think about it, that is a hemp derived CBD, so you're not getting all of the cannabinoids.
I did not know that.
And well, that's also how it can be sold online and everything else, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Which I mean, there are still a lot of benefits with that, but you know, some people prefer to get the full spectrum.
Yeah. So let's tell the people that don't really know exactly what you're talking about.
Well, and I was just going to finish just by saying, like, I had experimented with using that as a topical and then had tried this on the same person. And their response was, I feel like I'm floating. Like, you really can tell with the THC compared to just CBD.
Mm-hmm.
It really does give that extra oomph. Like, it really does help a lot.
Right. Now, you said it wouldn't get you high, but how do they feel like they're floating? Just because their body wasn't aching anymore?
Exactly, because it's very, I would say for me, it's almost kind of numbing, like you're saying, you know, it's mm-hmm. like,
it just goes away.
Exactly.
It's crazy. It's really,
you know,
cool.
It's like when you have a headache and you take an ibuprofen, you don't necessarily say, I feel the ibuprofen. You just say, my head doesn't hurt anymore.
There you go.
You know?
There you go. And I just want to touch base on the hemp-derived CBD and the cannabis-derived CBD. I think we have touched base on it before, but it helps reiterating it to our new audience. But hemp-derived CBD, you can ship all across the country.
Yep.
And it is not, you're not getting the full spectrum. You're not getting all the cannabinoids that are active in the cannabis plant versus a hemp plant.
Correct.
They come from the same family, but they do not produce the same amount of cannabinoids, a diminishing amount in hemp, but it's still like beneficial. But nonetheless, if you can get cannabis derived CBD, it is definitely premium. It's going that extra mile that really does make a difference.
Well, and I'd even noticed that too, just in the extracts I was smoking as well, because I have tried CB Distillery has a isolate that you can dab.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, I've tried Blue River, had a full cannabis CBD. So of course, you know, I prefer the cannabis, but I'm on board with all of it.
Love it. Yeah. I'm glad we're getting somewhere.
I mean, if you can't get cannabis CBD, definitely get hemp CBD.
Mm-hmm.
And I was even seeing last night, I had gone to The Cave. It's a smoke shop in San Mateo, very popular. They had all these new products. They were gummies, gummy rings, worms, all that stuff in jars, same looking as that salve jar.
Mm-hmm.
And all hemp CBD.
Yeah, edible. I'd be worried about that. I mean, it's just like
but
getting gas station sushi or something. I mean, it's like
It depends, though. I mean, you know, some smoke shops do carry really good brands. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, they have glass in there that's ridiculous.
Definitely. I said those are the few and far between
but
smoke
yeah,
shops.
Be careful.
Yeah, be careful. Do your research first, especially on the company if they're an overnight company and don't really have a lot of background.
Well, no, I mean, the main concern is just where is the CBD sourced from? And a lot mm-hmm. of people don't think about that is that, you know, because it's illegal for them to import it from China. I don't want Chinese hemp CBD. They have different regulations. You know what I mean?
Yeah, agreed. And there's been found metals and imported CBD specifically from China. But also, I wanted to say that the potency on the CBD might, like if it says like a 10 milligram gummy, it might not be 10 milligrams. Like, I feel like that shit's true. Washed down. That's a
right,
opinion,
like,
cause
but do they have to be tested? Probably
right,
not.
Right. So
it's not like an actual cannabis THC edible where it's down to the minute little mm-hmm. test.
Every batch is tested. Yeah. This isn't tested. So,
but well, I don't know.
Do your research.
Yeah, for
do
sure.
your research. It's
because you're right. I don't know the different products and
believe me, if they are about their stuff, they will be promoting it. They will know their stuff. They will let you know that they know their stuff. So
yeah, we're looking out for y'all
yeah.
over here.
Yeah. You want to learn how to grow indoor marijuana?
Yeah.
Cannabis?
I do.
Well, personally, I love growing outdoors more because you get the beautiful sun. You get a little tan on. You get some vitamin D.
I love outside.
Yeah, I get you outside. It forces you to be outside. It's a great thing. I love it. But not everyone is as blessed as us to currently be living in the Bay Area and have weather that we can grow outdoors at least once a year. So most of America can't, and the main thing is if you can't grow outdoors, you grow indoors, and since you don't have a sun, you have a artificial light.
Which is your sun.
And you can have different levels of sun. You can have 100 watt or 300 watt, and it's going to be more intense or less intense. So,
do you have to have both? Because you sure as hell probably can't start out with a 300 watt like you throw in a newborn in the damn direct sunshine.
Right. So let's start with supplies. Like, what do you need? What do you need to start out with? Well, let's just go with basics. Let's say we're going to grow 1 to 4 plants. Nothing crazy. We're not doing a big indoor op.
say a little personal. Let's start with one.
let's start with a little
one. Or two.
Yeah, let's start with one or two. You're
going to
need a tent.
Babies here.
You're going to need a tent. Yep. You're going to need a tent only because if you grow without a tent.
What do you mean a tent, though? Like an enclosed?
An enclosure, yeah.
Enclosure.
That is going to bounce the light from.
Reflective.
Reflect the light off inside. Of the material inside onto the plants, onto the other sides of the leaf, not just the top.
And this is something I've seen you growing indoor that you can order like this in sheets.
Yeah, you can get like a little Mylar.
Mylar.
Basically, it's like a mirror kind of that you can put on the side.
Kind
of
like
tent.
Aluminum foil, but it's not. It's a different material, mm-hmm. but same concept.
Right. So you need a tent just because you want to be able to have its enclosed environment. You want it to be sanitary and not have any other elements coming in to your grow environment. You want to be as clean as possible. So you want a light, obviously. You want...
What type?
That's another topic that we can definitely talk to
somebody
more intelligent. But I would say CFL, which is compact fluorescent light, which is going to be your most common one. LED, which is going to be your most efficient and
probably low maintenance.
Yeah, low maintenance, but it's also
cooler.
Strong. So it's hard to start out a new little seed on a LED because usually they're so freaking bright they'll burn them up.
Right.
So you have to have like a small supplementary light to start them with because the new seed, just like a toddler, you can't leave it outside all day.
Yeah.
So it's just you want to do your research on what light to get because depending on how big your tent is, it might justify what you need because CFLs run harder, LEDs don't. And there's just
temperature wise.
Yeah, there's just different factors. But for the basics, a tent, wire hangers that you can move the light up and down on because you want to adjust
as it grows
the light size. Yeah. You want to have it close by the plant pretty much like a foot, foot and a half off the floor while they're new, while they're little clones. And then as they get taller, you want to move the light up. And let's see. You want
maybe a timer?
Definitely a timer. I know my buddy right now is currently growing in Florida, and he does it himself. I'm like, dude, don't rely on a human error.
He
doesn't have a timer. If it's $7,
I go up every time and open.
Yeah. What if you're not home? Yeah. Like, you gotta.
Well, it's just easier and more precise too. Like, mm-hmm. That's probably the most minute thing you don't want to worry about. You'd rather be putting that extra little bit of time into pruning it or.
Exactly.
And, you know,
yeah,
benefiting the plant instead of having to worry about the light.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. And it's
that's
just
a good tip.
Yep. And it's cheap too. So it's not like something that's like $100. Mm-hmm. It's an $8 to $12 timer on Amazon or Walmart, what have you. Let's see, you want to have various pot sizes. Honestly, what I tell people to start out with, if you have a little clone or a seed, start out with a red solo cup. Red solo cup. So start out with a little red solo cup and cut some holes in the bottom with scissors so the water has a little bit of drainage. Soil, you want to have good soil. You can't have Miracle-Gro or any like commercial soil. Because a lot of times it has too much nutrients in it, a lot more nitrogen than it needs, a lot more phosphorus, and it'll end up burning the plant up. It won't grow anywhere. You'll be like, what the heck? Well, do your research and see what's in your local town, because every town has a different soil that they use at the local shop. So do a little bit of research on that.
What's your generic brand you go with? Fox Farms?
Yeah, I mean, that's what's good about that is that's a decent soil for anyone. Can get it off of Amazon.
Right.
Even if you're in Canada, you can get it up there. It's going to be a little bit more shipping, but Fox Farms Ocean Forest is a good go-to overall.
What was the other one, like Black and Gold or?
Yeah, they're up in Humboldt. They only do California, unfortunately.
Lucky us.
Yeah, very lucky. So, pot sizes. So solo cup, maybe a 1 or 2 gallon. And then lastly, you'll want to move it into probably a 5 gallon. Depending on your tent size. The bigger the pot, the bigger the plant.
Hell yeah.
So
big buds, no boof.
And so what's cool about indoor is you tell it when you want it to flower. So veg.
Right, because you're not relying on the sun.
There
it's
we
all
go.
Controlled.
So tell us why that is when you flip the switch. What happens? Like when you go from 18 to 24 hours to 12 hours.
Well, then the plant starts to actually think that it's dying, and then it goes into flowering, which is a really cool process. And it's just, you know, at that point, it now knows it's going into its next stage.
Mm-hmm. So it goes from.
Right? It's dying when it starts to flower. Like
that's its natural,
technically.
Dying cycle. Yep. So yeah, when
so
you.
So interesting.
When you go from 18 to 24 hours with your little seedling, and then it starts to get 1 foot tall, 2 foot, 3 foot, depending on your tent. You want to make sure that it doesn't get near 75% of the tent height, because usually when you start flowering, it'll grow another 20% to 30%, depending on the strain.
Well, and so I'm curious though, too, because you say a tent, which that's the most ideal. But could you grow this hypothetically in like an armoire that you take the shelves out or something? Or would that not be good because it gets way too hot, you know?
Yeah, that's the only thing is you can definitely do that. You see
or
stuff.
Or in a closet or something, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. You see, I mean, there's ideal conditions. It definitely depends person to person what you're working with. But heat is a big thing. If you get too hot, I mean, it's not even worth growing at that point at the condition. The climate isn't good for the cannabis. It's not going to thrive at all. You're going to end up with a not good product you don't want to smoke. But yes, you can grow in the side of your closet or an armoire, but you have to have a certain amount of circulation. So another key thing, I'm glad you brought that up, is an oscillating fan. You want a fan that rotates.
Mm-hmm.
Why that's important is
inside of your tent.
Yes.
So
small, like 6 to 12 inch.
Like a desk fan.
Yeah.
Maybe, or, okay.
Yep. You're not working with monsters, so you don't need nothing crazy. But
airflow.
Yeah, you want the airflow, and it's good to have it oscillating and not just directly on the plant, because the plant will start to grow in that direction if it's just directly on it.
Mm-hmm.
And also that wind is going to make the stem a lot thicker and bigger. It's going to be able to withstand a lot more, and it's just going to be a more healthy plant.
Because it's getting tossed around a little bit.
There we go.
Stress.
They like the stress. They do. They don't like a ton of it, but they like a low to medium amount.
Hmm.
And there's certain techniques that you can give the cannabis plant more stress to increase their yield or quality or what have you.
Cool.
Let's see, what else is there? It's always good to get a thermostat / humidifier gauge.
So that's just like a temperature reader, another digital item you can order on Amazon.
Yep. And that's cheap, $10 off of Amazon. And it'll record your high and lows for your humidity and temperature over the last 12 hours, I think it is. But it's always on. It's a very good gauge to have. Another thing is a pH meter, a little electronic pH meter.
And I was going to say, too, your nutrients. And then if you're doing indoor, maybe, you know, if you have one plant, you might want to get, like, an old milk jug that you rinse out, of course, and clean out, poke a hole in it. That way you can, you know, mix your nutrients up in a jug and something like that, you know?
Yep, exactly. And the pH meter is you want to test the pH after you add nutrients or even the water that you're putting in. And if your pH is off, I think the range right now is 5.8 to 6.2 pH is ideal. So if it's not, if it's out of that range, you basically want to get a little pH adjuster kit, which is like $2 off of Amazon.
So cool. This is all like very, affordable for
the
average person.
I would say if you're looking to grow 1 to 4 plants, let's say 1 to 2. If you're looking to grow 1 to 2 minimum, with tent, a decent light, I mean, fan, all the gauges, I would say 200, 250, something like that, depending on how much your soil is, nutrients and all that in your local area.
And hey, if you do a good job, Bubba, you're getting that in weed that you're smoking.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it's worth it.
Exactly. And you can use that tent and the nutrients and all that for multiple cycles. So
multiple plants.
Yeah, it's really an investment. It's not a every time thing. It really is not. Electric bill isn't too much, really. It's going to go up $10 to $20 maybe with not a crazy light. So it's not going to go up really high. So yeah, this is honestly worth it. And what's great about it is you know what you're putting in your plant. You know what you're spraying it with. You know what nutrients you're putting in it.
Yeah, but still, it is kind of a trippy, weird concept to think, like, I grew this and I'm about to smoke it. Like,
crazy. It is. It is a trip.
How?
Yeah.
You know, like, it's so like, cool. Wait, what?
It's so cool.
It's like when you grow your own vegetables, you know, and you eat it and you're just like, what? Like,
mesmerized.
I saw this when it was nothing and now it's here and I'm eating it. You know, it's just so trippy.
Yeah.
But it's awesome.
It's a beautiful thing, right? It's a trip. We're currently, me and Ray are looking at.
Like, we're looking up like, whoa.
We're literally looking up right now and we're looking at big old buds of forbidden fruit hanging above us and some chocolate grape diesel.
We like when our garage is like this.
Yeah, it smells like Christmas.
I was saying we should make some a mistletoe.
Yeah.
Like a bud that's a piece of mistletoe.
I love it. I think we should. Indoor growing, though, it's a cool thing to do. It's a really cool nurturing aspect I talk about all the time on my personal Instagram. I just love the nature nurture aspect, and it's very therapeutic for me to watch that. It sounds weird being like a manly man and watching a little freaking plant grow, but it's pretty cool. I enjoy it.
Super cool.
Yeah. So yeah, that's how you grow cannabis indoors. There's a lot of specifics to it. I mean, you can go with, especially with like the soil and all that, you gotta do your research. The light size, like how big of a light you're going to use, you want to do your research heavy. The tent size, where you can put a tent. Oh, another thing, this is optional. Carbon filter.
Yeah.
Let's say your stepbrother, my stepbrother specifically, when I grew this indoors in Daytona, this was like right after the Marine Corps when I started smoking. And he didn't like the smell of weed. I mean, hated the smell of smoke. And he didn't really know what the plant smell was. But I had to get a carbon filter. And a carbon filter cuts out all the smell. And so you have a little external fan outside the box or tent that you're using. And it's going to create a negative vacuum with like a hole in your tent. It's going to suck out the air in the from the tent into the polar fan and to the carbon filter. And then from there,
it's like a smojo when you're blowing it through the smojo. And
the fuck is a smojo?
It's a device that you blow, like if you're trying to smoke inside and not smell it, like you blow it through a basically like
yeah,
a tube.
Yeah. Okay, I know what you're talking about.
Smell it.
I was like, what the heck? That's funny.
I was also thinking that I'm that friend that comes to see you years later, like hasn't seen you in years because you've been in the military, comes to reunite and hang out in Daytona and smokes weed inside your house and gets you in trouble.
Oh my God. She really did. I swear. That's hilarious.
Good times. Over here like growing in your closet. He doesn't even know. I like take one puff, like
one puff, yeah, out the bong, and she gets me in trouble.
That's what's
comes
crazy
to my room.
Too is he still didn't know you were growing.
Nope. So I'd have to be tactful of when I would open the doors to the tent because it would smell. I mean, when they don't really smell when they're in veg, but when they start to get flowering, they start to stink. So
in a good way.
I had to open it up when he was sleeping or when he wasn't home. So I had to like time it kind of. It was pretty funny. But
which made it kind of fun, I bet.
Yeah, it did. It did. And now I'm growing freaking trees. Like 10-foot tall trees in my backyard. What the
I've seen people grow some trees. What was I even just saying? I saw some people grow some trees indoor like that. Like,
yeah,
not
that's crazy.
As obviously big and bulky as they are outdoor.
Think about the mother room at Airfield. Yeah. Pretty cool. Vendor day. What's going on? November 17th, next Saturday.
November 17th. We're going to be out at Purple Lotus, a dispensary here in San Jose, and we are doing basically a podcast recording live. So we're going to be out there hanging out. There's some other vendors out there, Papa and Barkley.
I Heart Jane. Rove Brand. We're going to have the head grower of Purple Lotus.
That's going to be sick.
And he runs also Green Valley Farms. Louis Acosta, he's a musician, obviously indulges in cannabis. We're going to have to pick his brain.
We're going to get some entertainment too.
Yeah, so we got, and then of course, the main, the OG, the GOAT, the man that's seen it all.
Well, right before that too, Kana Edibles. Kana Treats.
Yeah.
They're gonna be there. But Ed Rosenthal.
That's crazy. That's crazy. I'm super excited.
Yeah, I'm excited to pick his brain.
The GOAT.
He's literally the OG.
The GOAT. I can't believe that's so cool. So that'll be all day event, and that's at Purple Lotus.
Yep, November 17th. See y'all there.
Heck yeah. What time? It starts at 1, correct?
Yep, 1 to 5.
Cool. There we go. And Emerald Cup, while we're at it, what else is going on?
Emerald
December 14th,
Cup.
15th?
That'll be so fun. Yeah, that's a two-day event. They have a whole lineup of musicians and stuff, too. But that's, you know, all kinds of vendors. So I think, too, they're going to be able to actually sell.
Oh, really?
There.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you can bring your own as well, I would assume.
That's how Cannabis Cup was, but I'm not 100% sure. I think they're still working out some of those kinks, but it is in the same spot, Sonoma County Fairgrounds.
Okay.
So up a little north.
Yeah, in Santa Rosa. Okay. Do you know how much ticket prices are?
I know that the single days are sold out. You can only buy a weekend pass now.
Okay.
So you have to buy both days.
Cool. There you go. Well, you'll see us there.
But I want to say it's like at least $100 a day.
Oh, I'll be there. At least one day we will be there for sure.
Yeah.
And I'm glad we won't be going home until later. But
like a few days after that, yeah.
Yep, and so we will be in Florida, and we'll be doing some recording there.
That's exciting news, too.
And it is still the Wild West over there. I was talking to some Floridians and some buddies back home, and they're saying that there's still no cannabis people. Like, it's very few and far between, and it's just like...
Cool. So we'll link back up with Lauren, see how Knox is doing.
Can't wait. Yeah, I can't wait to hear
about some other dispensaries out there.
What's going on?
Yeah.
I know she's got so much more to update and touch base on. There's so much more happening there. I can't wait to talk to her.
And then all I can think about is the food.
For real.
Different food choices there, but...
For real. So midterm elections just happened. And the biggest one being...
Michigan
is now...
Legal.
So
recreational and medical.
It is medical and recreational, correct. So you can be 21 and up, and as long as you have a government-issued ID, you can walk in and buy cannabis. Yeah. Ohio cities approved local marijuana decriminalization measures, and a number of Wisconsin counties and cities strongly approved of the non-binding ballot questions calling for a cannabis reform. Nah, North Dakota didn't get the call. They didn't get it approved. Maybe next time, but that's okay. And then we also have Utah is medical now as well, and Missouri.
Cool.
Is medical as well. So we are getting there.
Well, I read a statistic too that it was saying, you know, over like 7 million Americans have access to cannabis now, and that's around 24% of our country now has some sort of access to cannabis, whether that's medical or recreational. 24%.
That's huge. Awesome. Compared to 1%.
When you think of like 1 in 4 people, like that's progress for sure.
Yes, it is. And another freaking huge thing is Jeff Sessions today resigned.
I saw that.
From GA, from General Attorney.
I heard he might have gotten fired, though, by Trump. But I don't know if that's 100%. I don't know the speculation on that. He could have left, could have. We never know.
Yeah, who cares?
Could have been mutual, whatever. He's a gone.
He's gone.
Yeah, dude, we're lighting up everywhere for that shit.
Yeah, so we...
Peace out.
I know Trump sees the dollar signs. He's gonna make it federal legal. Or if anything, he'll just leave it up to the states. Be like, look, this is not a Schedule 1 anymore.
Which we don't, I mean, yeah, we'll see. I hope so.
I hope so, too. Or if he doesn't do it now, I guarantee he'll do it before the election. So he can try and get a re-election or what have you. But I know he sees the money signs. He's a businessman. He'll soon. So, yeah, that's all we got for you. Oh, girl, tell me about your peak.
I know, I'm about to go hit it. It's so nice just because it's so portable. If you guys haven't checked it out, Puffco, P-U-F-F-C-O. They are actually based out of Brooklyn, which is sick.
Brooklyn.
Yeah. We in the streets, bitch.
In the streets.
No, so it's super cool. It's actually the best portable e-rig electronic. So this is not even something I have to plug in like an e-nail. It's like battery operated.
So you burn extracts in there, correct?
Yep, completely portable. It has a ceramic bowl. So you load your dabs in there, double click a button. It has a certain heat cycle. There's 4 different temperatures. I typically like the second temperature up. There's 4. So
okay. Cool.
And yeah, and I just got a new attachment for it, which is another cool thing. A lot of glass artists have been creating pieces to supplement the normal glass that comes with the peak.
Got to customize everything.
There you go.
It's like a car.
So I got a new attachment. I got a bubble cap, which was cool because it only really had a traditional carb cap. And with the bubble cap, it's more of a directional.
So what are these things you're talking about? Because some people might not know what a bubble cap is for an e-rig.
True. So, it's just like when you take any sort of dab where you're using a carb cap, you're capping the nail. So you're putting something on, you know.
On top of the heating elements.
Right.
Why? To burn it more efficiently, correct?
Well, to get more smell. It's like when you're pulling the bowl out of the stem. It's just like
you're putting the bowl back in to like relight it, to like get more smoke to accumulate, to like burn better.
The bubble cap, yeah, is just more helpful because it's directional. I mean, if you don't dab, you're not really gonna know what I'm talking about, but
yeah,
this is definitely something for more of like a connoisseur.
Cool.
But yeah, it's super fun, and of course I love it because it's super portable. I can have it right by my bed if I want. I can bring it to the beach if I want. I even was hiding it in the bathroom of my aunt's house, like, and would just dip off in the bathroom, hit the peak, blow it outside, you know?
That's hilarious. I love it.
So it's great. I'm super happy with it.
Speaking of that, won't the CEO of that company be at Emerald Cup?
He will be at Emerald Cup. Okay. I watch him on his Instagram Live, Jolly Roger NYC. And yeah, I'm excited. I'm looking forward to meeting him and kind of picking his brain.
Heck yeah, he's a cool guy.
Because I mean, they've only been around for a year, and it seems like they've come so far. So it's really cool.
Yeah, I definitely say they're their leader.
Well, I wouldn't say they've actually been around for a year. That's incorrect. The Peak has been around for a year, but they have, you know, other products. I have their Plus, their Pen, which, you know, if you're big into vaping and you like the cartridges. This is similar, but you use your own extract. So if I'm going and buying my dabs, I just use my own dabs and in a similar fashion, load that into a bowl, but it's just on a smaller scale. It's like just a vape pen.
Yeah, it's a Puffco, just really small. Yep. So versus going to the store and just buying the cartridge that's already pre-filled with its own strain or extract or what have you, you're filling it up with your special extract that you got.
Well, so, and because in the extract, yeah, because the extract world is expanding, and it just depends on what you like, because the cartridges are what we've talked about, all distillate, which in the is pretty much the purest form of THC. All the terpenes and the flavor and all the strain pretty much is taken out. It's just the part that gets you high.
Right.
And then in those cartridges, then they reintroduce
terpenes.
The terpenes for whatever strain they want, which is why they're more flavorful. But in that aspect, you know, that's totally different than smoking the actual flower, where you're getting all the plant matter and the cannabinoids and same compared to a dab. If you're smoking your own dab, I mean, that's totally different than a distillate. You could be smoking crumble, shatter, sauce.
It's a different, just a different high.
So it's cool.
Yeah, that, and I think what's cool about it is I don't always want to smoke that pen that has the same strain.
Right.
You can switch it up with the Puffco, and you can say, oh, I'm going to smoke this strain. And then next go around, in 2 hours, I'm going to smoke this strain.
Exactly.
Where the pen, you have to use the whole thing up, or you have to get another cartridge, where you can get a small amount of extract and use it in the Puffco.
Well, and the Puffco is good just because convenience, too. And that's why I normally even get a vape in the first place. So
it's convenience, 100%.
There you go.
And portability.
Yep.
Yep. Cool. Well, that is our episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. As always, follow us on the gram, America's Podcast. And then, Ray, what's your name, girl?
Broccoli Bay 420.
All right. And then I'm Perform Higher. So y'all will catch us. And
heck yeah, lots of exciting stuff coming. Yeah. Stay high. No boof.
No boof. Hey, we got a lot of stuff coming our way. Big stuff happening. We can't go into detail, but stay tuned.
Yeah, follow us.
Peace out. It's America's Podcast, baby.
Later, Gators.
Later.
Bye, Mernon.